Hello people, so today I'm going to demonstrate you the method to find out the focal length of a convex lens. So here we have a convex converging lens on a lens holder, and the lens holder is kept on a stand, and the lens holder is actually movable. I can drag it on left and right side, and what you have basically on behind the lens is a white background that is called a screen, and this stand is extending backwards as well, right? So now, if you look at the image has inverted letters written on it. So that's a real image, and all real images are inverted. Anyhow, since the image is obtained on the screen, it has to be a real image, and real images are inverted. So as you can check by yourself, the letters are inverted. Now, you might be wondering whose image is this. Now, this is the image of a window and two stickers over here. Now these letters TGES are written in an erect way, but if you look in the image, the letters are written in inverted fashion because it's a real image and real images are inverted in nature, right? And now, since these two are the objects, the sticker and the window, it is comparatively at a very large distance from my lens. So compared to the focal length, the object distance is very large. So I'm going to consider this as object at infinity. Now parallel rays from infinity are falling on the lens, and finally they are being converging on the screen. Now I have to find out the best point where I get the highest sharpness. So if I move, you can see that the image gets blurred. So I have to move this lens in such a way I get the highest sharpness. Okay, this is it. Now, since if you have scale, you can measure the distance from the screen to the lens, and it appears to be roughly around 15 to 16 centimeters. Yeah, it is approximately 15 centimeters, and there are readings also over here. So you can even subtract these two readings and find the focal length. So the focal length of this lens is approximately 15 centimeters, and I'm getting it by trial and error method by object at infinity. I will also perform a demonstration in which we can also find out the object, and we can find out the focal length by putting needles at the center of curvature. And we will also get the image at center of the curvature on the other side, right? So that's what we call as 2F. So if the object is at 2F, the image must be at 2F, and half the object distance, that is 2F, we'll get the focal length. So we'll again demonstrate that very shortly.